We have learnt about the various parts of human reproductive system as well as its functions. Now let us discuss a closely related topic, reproductive health. What is meant by reproductive health? What do we understand by this term? This term simply refers to the healthy reproductive organs with the normal functions. According to the World Health Organization, WHO, that is World Health Organization, have defined reproductive health as the total well-being, of a person in all aspects. These aspects are, first aspect is physical, that means the person should be physically healthy, there should be no any disease, mental, that person should be mentally strong, and social. That person should be social. So these are the three main aspects of the health: physical, mental, and social. So reproductive health is defined as a total well-being of a person physically, mentally, and socially. It also includes the mental, it includes the emotional behavior of a person. Now why is it significant to maintain the reproductive health, and what are the methods taken up to achieve it? Let us examine them. Now we will be discussing about the problems and strategies associated with reproductive health. Which are the various problems faced by the people in concern with the reproductive health? India was among the first countries in the world to initiate the action plans. India has started family planning programs to reduce the size of the family. This program has become very famous. Before this family planning program, there were many number of kids in the families. The number was common, 9 to 10 kids in each family, even more than 10 kids. So India has initiated a program, family planning. So it helps to reduce the number of kids in a family. So all the kids will get proper things. It was initiated in the year 1951 and it was periodically assessed over the past decades. Improved programs covering wider reproduction related areas are currently in operation under the popular name Reproductive and Child Health Care. In short, it is written as RCH. RCH stands for Reproductive and Child Health Care Programs. So this program is there to create awareness among people about various reproduction related aspects and providing facilities and support for building up a reproductively healthy society. That's why this RCH program is there. RCH stands for Reproductive and Child Health Care. With the help of the audiovisual and print media, government had taken help of the audiovisual aids such as television, radio, etc. to create the awareness, as well as the print media, that is newspaper, to create the awareness among people about the reproductive health, as well as non-governmental agencies also. They have taken various steps to create awareness among the people about reproduction related aspects. Parents, other close relatives, teachers, as well as friends, they also play important role in sharing the information among the adolescents. Adolescents as well as people who are able to reproduce, they should have proper information regarding this. So government has also introduced sex education in school syllabus. So what is the purpose of this sex education? The students should get, the adolescents should get proper and scientific information about their sexual organs, then about the hygienic sex, safe and hygienic sexual practices, sexual transmitted diseases, the problems associated with it, as well as AIDS. It would help the people, especially in the adolescent age group, to to lead a reproductive healthy life. Educating people, especially fertile people, those who are in the marriageable age groups, about available birth control techniques, care of pregnant mothers, then postnatal care of the mother, and the importance of breastfeeding, equal importance to the male as well as the female child. It would address the importance of bringing up socially conscious families of desired size. So it gave importance to small families. You might have heard about Hum Do, Hamare Do, means they have told about the importance of the small sized families. If there are small sized families, the kids get equal opportunities as the basic needs are considered. The awareness of problems due to uncontrolled population growth, social ills like sex abuse and sex related crimes need to be created to enable people to think and take up necessary steps to prevent them and thereby build up a socially responsible and healthy society. It is the purpose of a sex education to create awareness about the sex related crimes and to build a healthy society. This is the purpose of a sex education. Successful implementations of various action plans to attain reproductive health requires infrastructural facilities, professional expertise, and the material support. These are essential to provide medical assistance and care to people in reproduction related problems like pregnancy, delivery, STDs, STDs that is sexually transmitted diseases, abortion, contraception, menstrual problems, etc. There should be a ban on the amniocentesis. What is meant by amniocentesis? Amniocentesis means the fetal sex determination. It should be banned. Can you tell why it should be banned? Because it leads to the female infanticide. Amniocentesis means a fetal sex determination test which is based on the chromosomal pattern in the amniotic fluid surrounding the embryo. For sex determination to legally check increased female feticides as well as massive child immunization. You are familiar with the child immunization programs in India. There is research on various reproduction related areas. You might have heard about the tablet Saheli. Saheli is a oral contraceptive pill which helps to reduce the size of a family because it is a oral contraceptive pill, and it had been developed by the Indian scientists, the scientists at Central Drug Research Institute, CDRI, in Lucknow. They have developed a oral contraceptive pill, Saheli. Better awareness about sex related matters, increased number of the medically assisted deliveries, and better postnatal care leading to decreased maternal and infant mortality rates, increase the number of couples with small families, better detection and cure of STDs, and overall increased medical facilities for all sex related problems, etc. All indicate improved reproductive health of a society.